Pancreatic cancer is one of the most difficult diagnoses and challenging clinical diseases that we face. Most times patients will develop symptoms that occurs fairly advanced in the disease. And those symptoms could include a darkening of the urine, a lighting of the stools, and yellowing of the eyes called jaundice. Typically, if those symptoms occur, the patients should seek medical care right away and ultimately get to specialty care for the treatment of the underlying tumor. Patients who have cancers or tumors in the body or tail of the pancreas, which is the end of the pancreas, typically don't present with those symptoms, but will present with symptoms of abdominal or back pain much later in the course of their disease, and again, should seek medical attention and specialty care to treat the underlying condition. Pancreatic cancer occurs in 40 to 50,000 patients each year in the United States and is the fourth leading cause of cancer deaths. The treatments for pancreatic cancer include surgery, chemotherapy, and radiation. However, the only cure for pancreatic cancer is surgery, actually removal of the tumor and then reconnection of the remainder of the pancreas and organs to the intestinal tract. Oftentimes, patients will have a combination of surgery plus chemotherapy and radiation in order to prevent the tumor from coming back in the future. Other patients who present with more advanced disease can only receive chemotherapy and radiation alone, and typically that is not curative. So here at George Washington University Hospital, we have two unique treatments for pancreatic cancer. One is minimally invasive surgery, and two is advanced vascular reconstruction or blood vessel reconstruction for tumors that are more advanced. The first technique involves using small incisions and using a camera in the operating room and long instruments in order to mobilize the tumor and do a resection. And the benefit of that is that there is less pain and a faster recovery after surgery for patients who undergo minimally invasive surgery. Therefore, they can go on to get the second stage of their treatment in a much better condition and much faster than they would if they had undergone traditional open operations. And as our chemotherapy improves, which it will, then those patients more likely will have a better outcome over time. Second treatment involves patients who have more advanced disease. One of the unique features about pancreatic cancer is that as it grows, it can oftentimes involve the blood vessels that carry blood to and from the remainder of the small intestines. And traditionally, patients who had those tumors that involved the blood vessels were not considered candidates for surgery and therefore would get chemotherapy and radiation alone, which we know is not curative. Now we're able to offer patients upfront radiation treatments to those blood vessels as well as chemotherapy. And as long as their cancers remain stable, then they're eligible to have a total pancreatectomy, that is removal of the entire pancreas, and also removal of segments of the blood vessels and reconstruction. And we've seen that those patients do the same as patients who had no blood vessel involvement. And so we're able to offer surgery to a much larger proportion of patients and hopefully end up with a better outcome for a larger pool of patients than would otherwise been offered in the past. So one of the more exciting areas of cancer therapy right now are techniques and treatments that utilize our own immune system to attack cancer cells. And we think that this is the future for cancer treatments. By figuring out why your immune system does not attack cancer like it attacks a bacteria or a virus, we now have drugs that allow the immune system to recognize cancer cells and therefore go and attack those cancer cells just like they attack a common cold or a common virus. We think the combination of those therapies, along with the new surgical treatments that we offer here at George Washington University Hospital, will provide better outcomes for patients with pancreatic cancer and will provide a longer survival for patients with this dismal disease.